Integrated academics has been going on here at Barry Tech for many, many years. I've been here almost at the inception of it. What it is that a certified math, English, and science teachers go into the various careers and do the math, science, or English that's embedded within their careers. By doing so, the students who have the integration can then have the option, depending upon the school district's approval, to have a credit of math or a credit of science or a credit of English just by being in the career class here at Barry Tech. So if they need 3 years of math to graduate, if they only have 2 years of math in their home school, by being in a program that has integrated math, if they're in the program for 2 years, they are eligible to get their third credit of math by being in the career ed program. So this is really a plus. The math integration is at a higher level, commencement level mathematics, in carpentry. Carpentry, we use Pythagorean theorem, geometry. I never have the kids say to me, when am I going to use this? Because we use it. We use it in the shop. We use the math in the shop. We use the math in their career. It gives them a higher level of understanding.
When I first came here to Barry Tech to learn about small engine repair, I didn't really think that math would be a part of it, but it really is a very big part. One of the things I really like about integrating math into my field is that I really love small engines, but sometimes it gets very complicated, and especially with all the hands-on work. And adding math to the equation, even though it's not really my thing, it sometimes simplifies what I'm learning and makes it easier.
Engine functions, transmissions, science, we do a lot of the same thing. Chemical composition, coolants, for example, we could look at. And of course, English, one of the biggest things would be, of course, resumes and cover letters and learning to write and get prepared for their career. Today, for example, we learned about the mathematics of gear ratios, so how combining a smaller and a larger gear can change the direction of a driven axle or parts of the transmission to make it go reverse. We've also learned that by counting the teeth and doing the proper math procedure, we can figure out what the gear ratio is. And they also learned that if they have a gear ratio that they're trying to achieve and they have one gear, they can now figure out what number of teeth they'll need on the adjacent gear to achieve that gear ratio.
Here at Barry Tech for culinary, we get to learn what we need for the kitchen, you know, measurement cups, weighing, volume, all of that stuff that you don't usually learn in your regular classroom, but things that pertain to specifically what you want to go into, like culinary arts. So I'm learning not trig, but I'm learning things that are specific and what I'll need in the kitchen instead of learning things that I won't need, having room to learn more about what I want to go into.